I'm Bernard Friedman, and I'm the owner of Santa Barbara Mariculture, Santa Barbara, California. Yeah, so we're in the harbor here. I'm on the boat Perseverance. Perseverance was purpose-built, longline boat. It's 30 feet, so it's one of a kind boat. So longlines are just basically two anchors with a rope in between, and it's got floats on it. And what makes this special is that it's a mile offshore in 80 feet of water. And so this is California's first and only offshore shellfish farm, and we're currently growing kelp as well. I first got started as a commercial diver, scraping mussels off of oil platforms and selling them for food. That was in 1998. And I've been doing it since 2002 on this site. We're expanding a lot into kelp, becoming more of a research facility, because obviously you need to figure out what animals you want to grow if you want to promote offshore aquaculture. So I'm trying to be that research facility.
This is all self-contained, right? This is one big self-contained mussel processing, harvesting, feeding, everything happens right here, right?
That's right, yeah, because real estate in Santa Barbara is out of control. And has...
tell me a little bit about the farm.
All right, so this farm is actually really special because it's California's only open ocean farm. It's about a mile offshore. It's in roughly about 80 feet of water. It is a farm that like no other. I mean, it's, as you saw out there, it was a lot of current, a lot of swell. You got seasick.
I was doing just fine until right about now.
It's a crazy working, beautiful environment. I throw long lines out there. The long lines are basically just two anchors with a rope between the anchor, and they're just floated up at a certain depth, and I can raise and lower those long lines. And I just hang shellfish and seaweed on these long lines, and I see if they grow. It's very hard endeavor. I've held my head in my hand a few times, and I've quit. But I really love what I do, and so I've geared my business so that at least I can always have a job. I mean, that was always the goal: is have a job for myself, have a profession. You know, I've always been good on the ocean. I've always had a talent for it, had a knack for it, and it's just always something I've gravitated towards, and somehow I figured it out, and I feel very blessed to have this job, but it's not an easy one to have, and it takes a lifetime to figure it out. I think the future with global climate change, our food is going to be coming from the ocean. In 100 years time, we could be eating the majority of our food from the ocean. As we go through these drought cycles and farms dry up, we're going to need to source our food from somewhere. That's why I gravitate towards shellfish and algae, is because the inputs are just your sweat, blood, and tears, and seawater. And so, you know, you don't have to water them, you don't have to feed them, but you do have to give them a lot of TLC. You do have to work the lines, and you do have to organize all the time, because the ocean is on its own agenda, right? And so the ocean's constantly wants to do what it wants to do, and as a farmer, you are constantly having to, even though it's just shellfish, you're constantly have to work those lines and work those shellfish to make sure that you can make a living from it. So that's the sweat, blood, and tears. That's the input. And it's knowledgeable sweat, blood, and tears.
You just say there's a lot of love, right?
Just love. I think so.
I'm all out of love.
TLC, man, tender love and care. You know, that's what I think farming's really all about, man, is how much TLC you can give it.
And if you weren't doing this, what would you be doing?
I'd love to be a cowboy in another life. I would have been a cowboy, a really good cowboy. That is my second profession, yeah. But this is exactly the same. I mean, this is like the steel horse, and then that's the open range, and you just hurt your herding shellfish out there. And so I think it's very similar. So I love those wide open spaces.
For UC Davis Aquaculture, I'm Dr. Jackson Gross.